I'm going to show you what dry fly to use,
the best dry fly for trout,
and the overall best dry fly ever created. And we're starting right here, right now. But first, welcome to Bone Smoke Outdoors. I'm your host, Jack. And hey, if you're not subscribed, hit that subscribe button so I can bring you more awesome tips and tricks just like this one. We got merch live down below. Make sure you check it out. It's really good stuff. It'll fit you well. Before I go into the best flies for you, I want you to know how to choose the fly for any situation. There's a couple ways you can choose different flies depending on the situation you're at. If you don't know how to choose a fly, there's a couple different ways to figure out what fly you should throw. Because let's be real, you can't just go to the river, throw a random fly and expect to catch a fish. You've got to match it with something. You got to know what the fish are keying in on, what bugs are hatching, and the time of year. The ways you know all that are pretty simple, actually. Number one, a simple Google search. Follow it by the month and your area and you'll find some of the most important data. Like what hatches generally happen that month, what coloring they're liking. I use Google all the time for plenty of fly fishing stuff. Number two is pretty simple. Go to your fly shop when you go to buy your flies and ask them what's hitting and why. Ask them a little bit about your area. Ask them what hits depending on what month, and ask them for like a good starter kit that'll last you this summer. These guys are really fishing when they're not working. They talk to all the fishermen coming in and out of their shop, so they have an understanding of what was hitting and why. And they do nothing but sell flies all the time. Their information is gonna be super pertinent to the flies that you're gonna wanna throw. Number four, you can also get tons of good data from your local fishing game. A lot of their websites have hatches and information about the bugs in the river. And the last one, but I would say most important, is a little bit of self-reliance. Anytime you're out on the river, always pay attention to what bugs are around you. Different hatches are happening different times of day, and there's different colors of bugs hatching depending on the time of day. So if you're paying attention to what's around you, it could catch you a giant fish. I've done this before, plenty of times. Once you understand how bugs hatch and when and how to match the hatch, you're really self-reliant. You don't need most of those other ways. I still always ask the fly shop what's hitting. That gives me an idea of what to buy. But then when I'm out there, I'm always paying attention to what's around me. I know we're talking about dry flies, but the same extent it works for subsurface. Look underwater, see what's down there. It could catch you big fish. Remember when you're new to not leave the fly shop until you buy some sort of floatant, gink or whatever. Floatant's something that you lather up on your fly and it's water repellent and it helps your fly float. When you're new, your mending skills and stuff like that aren't prime, so your flies end up sinking a lot quicker unless you have floatant. So that's how you figure out what dry fly to use. Now we're gonna move on and talk about the best dry flies for trout. But first, if you're not already subscribed and you're getting value out of this, make sure you hit that subscribe button so I can bring you more content just like this. Now I'm not gonna cover all the dry flies right now. That would be way too long. So I'm just gonna give you five good dry flies to use that'll work pretty much all dry fly season. And we're gonna talk about the best fly fishing fly ever created. Fly number one, the Stimulator. In my area, yellow seems to be what works the best. However, sometimes I catch them on red. They have green stimulators. It's an attractive fly that looks like most big bugs. That looks like a range of different bugs. And they double up as a hopper if you don't have a hopper in your arsenal of flies. Now the yellow stimulator is a bigger fly, so it's good for faster water. I have a lot of luck with it on river bends that are moving kind of fast. The elk-haired caddis is another fly that's freaking fantastic. It's basically just the adult representation of the caddis fly, but the thing is, you can also use it for other bugs. I talked about using the stimulator for hoppers. You can do the same thing with the elk-haired caddis. You can also use the elk-haired caddis for a good chunk of the stoneflies, depending on the coloring. I guarantee you that if you asked any fly fisherman, they would have an elk-haired caddis on hand. That's how good of a fly it is. It's a larger fly, so I recommend using it in faster water. Trust me when I say large flies and fast water go really well together. If you put just a little bit of floating on those suckers, they'll float like all day. This next fly is kind of unique in the sense of it doesn't look like a bug, and it's not supposed to. Well, I should correct myself. It's supposed to look like a bug, just not any specific bug. It's the Royal Coachman. It's a stimulant fly, kind of like the stimulators, just designed to be a reactionary fly. They see it and they're like, ooh, I'm hungry. The Coachman's similar. It's a smaller fly, good for, you know, slower waters, or you can use them in fast water too, but I tend to use smaller flies in slower water. It's harder for the fish to tell that it's a fake fly if it's smaller in slow water. They get up to those big flies sometimes and they can see that it's not real. Which is called being rejected, and we don't like being rejected. But girls or fish, I've had plenty of luck with the Royal Coachman over the years, and it's a fly that I just keep on me at all times. Now we're really starting to get into the meat here, and now we're gonna start talking about my two favorite flies. Now we're gonna talk about the March Brown. Now the March Brown is a phenomenal fly. Stemming from Europe, we in the US have adopted our own version of it, but it's basically just a mayfly. And let me just say real quick that the March Brown has a very classic look to it. I mean, it looks like a fly that you would see in like the river runs through it, or you would imagine someone in the olden days fly fishing with. It is a beautiful fly. Although you're gonna have your best luck early on in the dry fly season with the March Brown, it still kills it throughout the rest of the year. I mean, there comes a point in dry fly season where pretty much most flies just work towards the end of the year, August. August is a good month to use whatever fly you got. By the time August rolls around, pretty much all bugs are free game to fish. I like the March Brown because brown's kind of a neutral color. It doesn't stick out like a dark black fly. It's not a light colored yellow. It covers a variety of needed colors to match. It can kind of match pretty decent with yellow. It can kind of match pretty decent with green. When green drakes are popping, you can definitely throw a March Brown and still get fish. Now one time, I was in the middle of a green drake hatch, but I had nothing green. I threw a March Brown and I started slaying those fish. Now granted, it's not a green fly, but I still started slaying the fish. They were hitting the brown pretty much as they were hitting the green drakes. All right, now we're gonna talk about it. The fly, the most important fly, the most successful fly, the fly that you have to have in your dry fly bag at all times. The fly that has the most recorded catches out of all the flies put together. But first, if you wanna help this channel monetarily, there's a couple links you can do that down below. I have custom Bone Smoke Outdoors merchandise in the bonfire link. I got some really cool stuff. We got hoodies, we got long sleeves, short sleeves, baseball tees, we got blues, we got greens, we got reds, we got black. So check it out. All the support is getting turned right back into the channel. So you're gonna help me get better audio, better quality, and overall better videos for you. Okay, the number one fly in the world is none other than the Adams dry fly. The Adams is just a dry fly that happens to look like several different bugs. It looks like an adult midge or mayfly. It's neutral coloring, so it blends in with other colors of flies. You can throw it with slight variants of coloring and still catch fish. It's tied with mostly grizzly hackle, but I have seen some weird variants of the Adams that also work really good. My favorite's the parachute style because you can see it in the water. You can get really, really, really small Adams, or you can get them pretty big, and all seem to work good for different situations. Here's a parachute style. Now the Adams has a grayish body and the brownish grizzly hackle, and it really, really works. This fly can literally be thrown any time of year during any hatch for pretty much any species of trout, and it just kills it. I guarantee you, if you were to talk to any experienced fly fisherman and you were to look through their flies, they would have several variants of the Adams. Those are the top flies that I would take. If you're experienced and you have a different idea, let me know in the comments below. I wanna know what you're taking and what you're catching fish on.